Hey everyone, welcome to my channel. Today, I want to show you how to create a UX case study. I'm going to design the case study of a website that I did in my last video. If you have not seen this video, please go and check this out. Video link in the description. Before I start this video, I want to talk about what happened in Syria and Turkey just few days back. Obviously, all of you guys watched the news and you should know that's one of the most deadliest earthquakes that happened since the year 2000. And if you are any way capable, please go and donate any amount possible. I think even a small amount will help those countries. I will link the official website in the description where you can go and donate. Okay, let's start this video. Creating an impactful UX case study has been a highly requested video in this channel. And today I want to discuss how you can approach this. Also, please do watch the video till the end since I have some exciting announcement at the end of the video. First of all, I'm going to tell you very few unpopular opinions and I know a lot of people is going to hate me for that, but it is important. I know few of you might have attended UX bootcamps or some workshop that have given you a definite format for UX case studies, where they want you to explain the entire process, showing wireframes, research, prototypes, and rest in your UX case study. And at the end, your case study actually looks like a college paper with a lot of theory and just some tiny design at the end. If you are doing this, please change this format right today. You need to understand that people are very visual and they want to consume the content as easily as possible. The reason I'm saying this is because most of the design recruiters don't have so much time to read your portfolio. So design recruiters look at more than 50 to 80 portfolios per day, and I'm telling you a very conservative numbers. You have at max of 5 seconds to grab their attention, so try to include some visual from the start of your project. So let's discuss the structure. UX case study should have these few important things and rest are optional. First, you should start from the why. In this section, you should explain what is the problem that you are solving and why it needs to be solved. You should be able to sell the problem to your viewers. Second is how and what. Start showing your design right here and explain the problem and its corresponding solution. Start showing how and what together. IE and user flow should also come in this step. Please stop showing persona and the entire research process here. If you at all want to show, then just write that you have interviewed X amount of customers and followed their research method. Do not go on writing all the research questions and the stuff. Nobody really cares about that. And I will tell you why I'm saying this. If you're getting interviewed in a man company, they actually expect you to know all of these things. Second, UX research is a complete career in itself, and researchers are highly trained in human psychology and research methods. And most of the agencies or man companies have dedicated design researchers. And so as a designer, they are not expecting you to show so much of process. If they at all ask you all of this during the interview, then just answer them the process that you have gone through. You don't need to complicate your case studies. So in the second step, you should show IA, user flow, the problem, and their corresponding solution. third step is to show the result or the impact of your design. Here, you can talk about the number of user adoption. Like after you did the design, X percentage of business growth has happened, or X number of customers have successfully adopted your product. If you are new to UX and showing your personal project, then you can say that since this is your personal project, you believe that upon user adoption, these designs are likely to be successful. Or you need to test this design with customer to understand the user adoption and iterate further on the design. The fourth step is where you want to show the learning you had in a project. The fifth step is the last step where you want to write the credits. You want to mention your role and who else was involved in this project. So this is the final format. First, I have included a hero image where I want the viewer attention, and you can also put a video over there. Second, I have mentioned about the client and what they do. Third, I have explained the problem statement, and right after this, I have also shown the final video or the prototype of the project. Please do not include your Figma links. Recruiters don't have time to open your link, sign into Figma, and then look at the prototype. You need to understand that your portfolio reflects you as a UX designer, and the target should be to make your viewer easily consume the content and understand it. Fourth, I have discussed the individual problems and how I have solved them with corresponding text and images. Fifth is where I have discussed the impact of the work. Sixth is optional, but you can share your learning of the project. Seventh is the credit section where you want to define your role and credit other designers who have worked with you. Also, you can add developers and PM in this. You can download the entire portfolio format that I've discussed in this video. The link is in the description. And if you're using this portfolio format, then please feel free to comment below or tag me in any other social media platform like Instagram or LinkedIn. Don't go still now. I still have some announcement left. But before that, I hope this video has helped you to understand how you can approach your UX case studies. So this is for you if you're absolutely new to the UX. It doesn't matter if you have never went to college or if you just want to switch your career to UX. There is a learning path for you. And I know this firsthand since I didn't go to design college. A lot of you have reached out to me asking that how to design your portfolio or how to get started on UX. And as I understand, most of you might not be clear about the learning path of UX and how you should approach it. So I've decided to create UX basics and how to create your UX portfolio from scratch. The series will include step-by-step process of how to learn UX, how to create your UX portfolio, and how to prepare for UX interviews. The videos will be entirely free and those will be uploaded in this channel. So I actually wanted to know that how many of you are actually interested in something like this, because before I want to spend my time and energy, I want to make sure that if people are interested in this thing at all. So please go to the link below in the description and please fill the form. That will notify me that if you are at all interested in something like this. Also, as usual, please subscribe, like, and comment, and hit that bell icon, and please share this video in other platforms if you have found value in this. Thank you so much for watching.